unity.
For peace in the whole world, for the stability of the holy churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For pious and Orthodox Christians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Archbishop and Father Silas, the Honorable Presbyterate, for the Diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our country, for the President, for all the public service, and for the armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and land, for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves, one another, and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Lord, have mercy.
Pray for all holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Trinity, and all
Son, and Holy Spirit, both now and ever unto the ages of ages. Amen. All immaculate Mother of God, you have been revealed at the golden throne of the King, and there are dozen flowers again for you.
Thank you.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
The peace from above and for the salvation of our souls let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For peace of the whole world, for the stability of the holy churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For pious and Orthodox Christians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Our Archbishop and Father, Sovereign, the Honorable Presbyter, the Diaconate, and Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our country, for the President, for all the public service, and for the armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord. For this city, for every city and land, for the faith who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For favorable weather, for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For deliverance, wrath, danger, necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our all holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. Proclaiming the together with Sir the glorified witness, the people on the glory of our Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and in the age of ages. Amen. Blessed is the entrance of your holy ones, always now and forever. Amen.
Sophia, Orthi, fervently.
Let us hear the Holy Gospel. Peace be unto all. The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Let us be attentive. The Lord said to his disciples, "He who hears you, hears me, and he who rejects you, rejects me, and he who rejects me, rejects him who sent me." The 70 returned with joy, saying, "Lord, even the demons are subject to us in your name." And he said to them, "I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. Behold, I have given you authority to tread upon serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall hurt you. Nevertheless, do not rejoice in this, that the spirits are subject to you, but rejoice that your names are written in heaven." In that same hour, he rejoiced in the Holy Spirit and said, "I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that you have hidden these things from the wise and understanding, and revealed them to babes. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious
who wrote about the wonderful works of our Lord. He is an individual
who saw with his own eyes, not just the works of the Lord as he was one of the 70, but remember, and this is the gospel that I would have picked for his day. The gospel I would have picked for his day was the resurrectional gospel, where he, the gospel writer Luke, and Cleopas were on the road to Emmaus after the Lord's resurrection, where they saw the Lord that they didn't recognize. That's the one I would have picked, because it's the one where we hear Christ open their eyes and open their minds to understand the scriptures. All the things that was written that were written about him in all of those books of the Old Testament. He opened their minds to understand it. Luke was a part of that. And so were the 12 apostles. To really understand everything in the Hebrew scripture that was said about Christ, prefiguring him. And how the Jews truly at that time, they didn't get it all right. They didn't understand all of the messianic prophecies. They missed a large portion of them. But Christ opened their minds and hearts to understand. Just to be a fly on the wall for that conversation, right? You know, just to be there to say, oh my goodness, look at these gospel passages. When I talked to some of the Jews personally and expressed to them that, hey, you know, read the Gospel of Matthew. He fulfilled a whole lot of scripture. And they'll return to me and they'll say, well, those were not the important prophecies. You know, and that's okay, well, there's some weight to that, but do you ever consider the fact that what you considered important, God may not have? Have you ever considered that? And where Matthew and Mark and Luke especially understood the fulfillment of prophecy. That's a huge portion, especially of Matthew's gospel. But in Luke, it was more of he was the evener of scales. The rich weren't going to stay rich for much longer. And the poor were never going to be poor again. Once Christ reigns, we will all be one. That's the thing that Luke's gospel is all about, which is why, you know, and he comes from a place of wealth. That's the thing that we don't understand about Luke. When he's writing about how the rich aren't going to stay rich much longer, it's because he comes from a place of wealth. The man was a doctor. The man was a physician. He's called the beloved physician in the epistle to the Colossians that we heard about today. He's spoken about in this way. And so, you know, no different than today, doctors at that time were well taken care of. They just weren't. They didn't want, they didn't need, they had an abundance, and they gave. They were respected. But Luke, he didn't remain, you know, a physician in practice so that he could win money. He remained a physician in the Lord, so that he could bring and turn souls to the Lord, to God. He walked the call as he went to all of the nations, not just to the Jews. Paul only went for a very short time to the Jews, very short time, just long enough to realize that this was a waste of his time. You know, and then he started preaching to everyone else, including our ancestors. We wouldn't be Christians. Paul wouldn't have had the strength to preach without the people supporting him, such as Luke. These are things that we have to focus on today. When you know, we talk about the 6 degrees of Kevin Bacon, where you can find like an actor, and eventually they were, if you go, they were in a movie with a movie with a movie with a movie, and there was Kevin Bacon, you know, like in that movie. You know, so you can find all of these different people. If I name an actor, Billy Crystal, and then, you know, you can go and follow his timeline to Kevin Bacon. Well, in the gospel today, we hear the Lord say, he who hears you, talking to the apostles now, hears me. He who rejects you, rejects me, says Christ. And he who rejects me, rejects him who sent him. You know, in other words, when you reject the words of the apostles, You are rejecting Christ. When you are rejecting what they are telling you, what they are saying to you, how they're asking you to live, you are rejecting the Father and the Son and the Spirit in the same breath. There's no 6 degrees anymore. It's 1 degree. That's it. There's no separation to this anymore. And that's a tough thing for us to understand. But it also shows us how God is using us, not just the clergy, all of us, to proclaim the message of the Lord. He wants this message to be shared. And we have to find both the verbal ways, using our minds and our heart, and using our minds and our mouths, but also the silent ways that sometimes speak a whole lot louder than our mouths ever could. Through our actions, through our love, through our dedication. This was Luke. That's all he was about, was supporting the one who was doing the work. And then in return, go figure, Christ turned it on him. He did the work too. Because the Lord is always going to have us. No one's going to be idle among the Lord Christ. Today we remember the activity of the Spirit in the person of Luke, the beloved physician. We also remember the personal thing, my heart and soul, the memory of another worker in that ministry, Father George Christian Levis, who passed away from cancer. That was a guide in my life. I would not be a priest without this man. And we remember the fact that his presbytera has lived vibrantly. She's a teacher. Still has raised a daughter that only was alive for her father for 6 months before he passed away. And also her daughter remembers the Lord. This is the extension of what St. Luke means to us, and how we have to show that activity in the Lord, and how we also live for Christ. So today, let us remember him, the beloved physician Luke. Let's keep into our hearts the George the priest, my brother, the celebrant of the Holy Mysteries, and let us find those ways not to be rejected. We're not looking to be rejected. We're trying to be heard. But we have to find appropriate and loving ways to do that. That's the hard part. Let us do that, and let us find that we're coming. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Again, again, peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, again, and countless times, we fall down before you, we plead before you, O good one who loves mankind, that you have regarded our prayer and cleansed our souls and bodies from every defilement of flesh and spirit. Grant to us to stand before your holy altar of sacrifice free of guilt and condemnation. Grant also, O God, to those who pray progress in life, faith, and spiritual understanding. Grant that they may always worship you with awe and love, partake of your holy mysteries without guilt or condemnation, and be worthy of your celestial kingdom. That ever guarded by your light, we may ascribe glory to you, to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages. Thank you. Let us complete our prayer to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
The precious gifts you presented, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
The holy house and for those who enter in with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
The whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless. Let us ask of the Lord.
Let us, O Lord.
For the peace of faithful God and guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Let us, O Lord.
The pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord. That which is good and beneficial for our souls and for peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Let
us ask for a Christian end to our life peaceful without shame and suffering, for good defense before the awesome judgment seat of Christ. Commemorating our all holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves, one another, and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
With the mercy of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life great Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And your spirit.
Let us love one another, that with oneness of mind we may confess. The doors in wisdom, let us be attentive. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from the heavens, who was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into the heavens and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the remission of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Let us stand aright, let us stand in awe, let us be attentive that we may present the holy offering in peace. Cherubim and seraphim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring aloft upon their wings. singing the victory, the triumphal hymn, exclaiming, proclaiming, and saying,
Son, of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Christ be with you all. Having commemorated all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts you presented and consecrated, let us pray to the Lord. That our God, who loves mankind, having accepted them in his holy and celestial and his full altars and offering his spiritual fragrance, may in return send down upon us the divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Having asked for the unity of the faith and for the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. Deca taxios unimas das potem meta parisia sacra de critos romanticaliste, set reperamium teo patera te legin, padri morno, quanti suranius, ai escrito romasu, et tetra facilirsu, in hirtu te romasu, os me granoni che pertinis, che nato de nuove de plusio, nos in insimero, che ac si vinta un libro d'animo, os qui disse fine, Beata, Signor, che emitis in legis in massa spiritum, alerisse in massa posto convenuti. Oti su est in Basilia, che dimitis, che doxa, patros, che tu iu, che tu aiu, pneuma, tos vincia, e che Jesus eonas, me honor. Irini passi, as che falassimon, to che dio clino me.
Amen. Chamber and rejoices with each draw man to run away.
Sos Deus Clausio, que e gloris fundite nomen suum, O God and Savior people, and bless your inheritance.
You may do for to have me,
always, now, and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen. That our mouths be filled with your praise, O Lord, that we may sing of your glory. You have made us worthy to partake of your holy mysteries. Keep us in your holiness, that on the day long we may be better for your righteousness. Alleluia.
Arise, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, immortal, life-giving and awesome mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Having prayed for a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us commend ourselves to one another, and our whole life to Christ our God. Thank you. We give thanks to you, Master, who loves mankind, benefactor of our souls, and on this, even on this very day, you have made us worthy of your heavenly and immortal mysteries. Make straight our path, fortify us in your fear, guard our life, make secure our steps through the prayers and supplications of the glorious Theotokos of Heavenly Virgin Mary and of all your saints. For you are our sanctification. Send up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, bless those who bless you, and sanctify those who put their trust in you. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Perfect the whole body of your church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them in return by your divine power, and forsake us not who have set our hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your churches, to the clergy, to our civic leaders, to the armed forces, and to all your people. For every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from you, the Father of lights. To you we give glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages. Intercessions of the Holy Glorious Apostle and Evangelist Luke be with all of you this day and all days. Thank you for those that serve the sun. We always pray for those that do that, no matter what service it is. We're always praying for the people who serve and for those that sing. It's a beautiful thing. I like that. At this time, as we are closing the service, we will have the communion prayers read. Those that are able to stay, you are welcome to do so. If you are not, we understand. When you have had to do the rightful part, would you like to give the mysterious gifts of immediate praise and great thanks to God? And say the following with fervent soul. Glory to you, O God. Glory to you, O God. Glory to you, O God.
I thank you, Lord my God, that you have not rejected me, a sinner, but have made me worthy to partake of your holy mystery. I thank you that you have permitted me, although I am unworthy, to receive your pure and heavenly gift. O Lord, Master, who died and rose for us, that you granted to us these awesome and life-giving mysteries for the well-being and sanctification of our souls and bodies. Let these gifts be for healing of my own soul and body, the averting of every evil, the illumination of the eyes of my heart, the peace of my spiritual powers, a faith unashamed, a love continuing to be fulfilled with wisdom, the observance of your commandments, the receiving of your divine grace, and the inheritance of your kingdom. Preserve us every holiness. May I always be mindful of your grace and no longer live for myself but for you, my master and benefactor. May I pass through this life in the hope of eternal life and the change of an everlasting rest, where the voices of your saints who feast are unceasing and your joy, beholding the ineffable beauty of your countenance is unending. For you, Christ our Lord, are true joy and gladness of those who love you, and all creation praises you forever. Amen. I thank you, Christ, the Master of our kingdom, the agent and creator of all things, for all the good gifts you have given me, and especially for the participation in the pure and life-giving mysteries. I pray you for good and loving Lord. Keep me under the protection and under the shadow of your wings. Grant me my last breath, I may with a pure conscience partake worthily of your gifts for the forgiveness of sins and for life eternal. For you are the breath of life, the source of holiness, the giver of all other things, and to you we give glory with the Father and the Holy Spirit, and all forever and to the ages of ages. Amen. You have voluntarily given me your flesh as food. You are a burning fire to be unworthy to not consume me, not my creator, rather penetrate into my memories, all my joints, my memories, my heart, and burn blood forms, all my memories, cleanse my soul, allow my hallowed thoughts, make firm my knees and my bones as well. Illumine my five senses and make my entire being vigilant with the fear of you. Watch over me always, shield and protect me from every deed and word that corrupts the soul, cleanse me, purify and put me in order. Adorn me, give me understanding and illumine me, make me your dwelling place of the saints only and no longer the place of sin, so that when you enter as if into your uncommon communion, every evil doer and every passion will flee from you, as from God. As advocates, I bring to you all the saints, the captains, and the ancient order of hosts, your forerunner, your wise apostles, and more than nature, apostles, your mother, whose prayers accept my compassion in Christ, make your servant a child of life. For in your goodness, you will accept the following life in our souls, and to you, our God and Master, you will give as it is right to live every day.
Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let your sacred body be unto me for eternal life and rest of life, for forgiveness of sins. Let this Eucharist be unto me for joy, health, and gladness. And in your awesome second coming, may be a sinner, worthy to stand at the right hand of your Lord, in the intercession of your pure mother. of all your saints. Amen.
O Lady Theotokos, light of my darkened soul, my hope, shelter, refuge, comfort, and joy, I thank you, for you have deemed me the unworthy one worthy to partake of the most pure body and of the precious blood of your Son. But you who gave birth to the true light, enlightened the spiritual eyes of my heart, you conceived the source of immortality, and now give life to me who am dead in sin. You, the compassionate mother of the merciful God, have mercy on me and give me penitence and contrition of heart and meekness in my thoughts, and an awakening of my thoughts from captivity. And grant me until my last breath to receive without condemnation the sanctification of your sacred mysteries for the healing of soul and body. Grant me tears of repentance and confession that I may praise and glorify you all the days of my life. For you are glorified to the ages. Amen.
For you are blessed and most glorified to the ages. Amen.
For you are blessed and most glorious, glorified to the ages. Amen.
Master, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word. And I, as the senior salvation that you have prepared for the presence of all people, I like to bring revelation to the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, the now and forever, to the ages of ages. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, forgive our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for your name's sake. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. O holy apostle and evangelist Luke, make intercession with our merciful God, that he may grant us forgiveness of our transgressions. Grace like a flame shining forth from your mouth has illumined the universe and disclosed to the world treasures of poverty. Show us the height of humility. Teaching by your own words, Father John Christopher, and so intercede with the word of Christ for God to save our souls.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Heaven received divine grace from heaven, which teach all men to adore the one God in three persons. All blessed the children, sister, and rightly praise you, for you are our teacher, you reveal in all things divine.
Both now and forever, to the ages of ages, amen. A protection of Christians, unshameable intercessor to our holy maker, unwavering. Reject not the prayer for Christ of those who are in sin. Instead, come to us, for you are good, your loving help. Bring unto us who are crying in faith. You hasten to intercede and speed not to supplicate. As a protection for all time, Theotokos, for those who honor.
Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, without corruption, you gave her to God the Lord. You have told us you to be magnified. In the name of the Father, bless.
May God be gracious unto us and bless us. May he cause his face to shine upon us and have mercy on us.
Amen.
Glory to your God. Glory to you.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Both now and ever, in the ages of ages. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Father, give a blessing.
May he who is wondrous among the saints, Christ, the true God, through the intercession of all Magdalene, all blameless, holy mother, holy glorious, praise the apostles, holy glorious, praise the martyrs of the government, God, the said Father. Our Father, among the saints, John Christian, Archbishop, the prophet, the Lord, holy clergy, the celebrant, the holy righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of the holy glorious apostles, all evangelists, Luke and Marina, the martyrs, remember the memory of the name of all the saints, the mercy and the saints, the spirit, universal, God, the most. Through the prayers of our Holy Father, Lord Jesus Christ our God, have mercy on us.